I assume that almost every company uses plastics somehow, and that the awareness of what's in that plastic varies a lot. A few companies, I think there are very few companies that have full materials disclosure, it said, so that their suppliers are obliged to tell exactly everything that's in the material they provide. That's very unique, and it's very problematic for many companies to get the information from the suppliers about the chemical content when it's not required, and because the supply chains are so long and complicated. So I know that for many companies that want to be responsible and that want to be able to say that they care about the consumer's health, it's the main workload for them to try to get the information on what's in the material that they are using in the products. And they spend much time on requiring information, and also much time on doing own chemical testing so that they can be certain about what materials they use. And those companies that don't have those resources or don't have that commitment to be very like responsible, caring, they probably don't know at all actually what's in their products. So I think there are all levels in there, but I know it's a huge undertaking to know what's in your products. It's not something every company do. That is definitely something that is needed and is being discussed, and many people are calling for the need to standardize plastics, and we should have fewer types of plastics to facilitate recycling and the whole issue. I think it can be difficult, it's impossible for an individual company to sort of decide that, but that we need to more on a political level, or maybe on a trade organization levels at least, to get companies working on this together, of course. It's something that needs to be a joint effort and to be quite a large organization for that to make a difference and to be possible. I definitely think that the argument of confidential business information has been used too much and where it's not needed. So it's been used as an excuse to not having to provide information for different reasons. It can also be because they don't know themselves exactly what's in the products. But for, I think this is something that is improving, although slightly or slowly. It's like more and more companies don't the exact chemical content or a list of chemicals in the product. It's really a threat to their business value. It's often other things that are more important. And even if you know the chemical content, you could probably not remake that product as it is. There are also other aspects to it. So I don't see that in most cases where confidential business information is claimed, it's really not the true reason behind not telling what's in the products. These companies, they spend a lot of time and resources on communicating with suppliers, trying to get hold of ingredients list, and also to do chemical testing to assure that their products are compliant then with their own standards that are higher than the regulation. So I would say that consumer clothes companies with a well-known brand are generally more responsible because they can also be put into scandals more easily. And then a chemical producing company or in the middle of the supply chain company that not many people have heard of, they also do not risk their reputation that much. So it's quite a big difference. We have been trying to work a lot with dialogue. So I think that the plastic producing companies, the brands and the recyclers need to talk more to each other about how these communication about the chemicals can be better transferred. So it's needed to know and to understand for the recycling facilities what they get into their facilities and what chemicals are in that. And it's needed for the companies that buy recycled materials to know what's in there. So it's very much about information and a strong need to improve this information of chemicals and that it can be tracked all along the life cycle.